Okay, so got a red oak here, 13 inches in diameter at the small end, which gives me a 9-inch cant. The cedar log flares out at the bottom here. There's also a pretty good check in it. I'm gonna turn that check so it's flat. Measuring off the concrete, it's 29 inches to the center of the log at that end. This end here is only 28, so this end could get picked up an inch. I think I'll do that. So we're going to cut parallel to the grain. This log has a little bit of dirt on it, so I'm going to sweep that off. It's a nice looking log. There's not any real defects in it. I want to get the metal detector. Okay, we should be good. Just give you a little insight here. Now my cant list that I have, so I don't have to be thinking about any math, says I'll get a 9-inch cant out of here. So if you hold the tape measure across the log, sort of level, 9 inches is right there. So if I measure up from here, it looks like a 2.5-inch cut will get me immediately to the cant. The problem with that is I might be wasting a board or two in here because of how straight this log is. So I'm going to come down here only 1 inch from the top and go through that way and see if I can get as much wood out of this thing as I can. See how the blade is. I don't know. I don't remember if I changed this blade recently or not.
foot.
Just check how the blade's cutting. Very nice. Very nice. Both ways. So far, we're quick. Beautiful red oak. There's not a mark in it. Wow. Very nice. This is right now, you can turn it all the way around and lay it flat, but because it has a nice edge on it, I might be able to lay it across, lay it perpendicular to the bump. As long as I can see a nice face on the stock, I'll let it like that. Measuring off the concrete to find the center of the tree because the concrete is flat and everything is adjusted for that. But looking good so far. I just want to take a little bit of a cut off of there so I can save the can. Probably a 1-inch cut to start off with. Thank you. that two sides cut there. You want to take that board out from underneath the lug. There's no reason for it to be there. Check at both ends of this log. I'll show you what I got here. This one's pretty big. However, 8'3" is about right here, so I'm going to lose most of it, almost all of it. And this one here doesn't seem to go in very far, maybe about 2 inches. So I'm not going to worry about that. I'm going to make another cut off the top there, a 1-inch cut. Because I'm a little short with the cam right where the bark is there. Give me a 1x4. I want to check the moisture content in this log. Now this has been sitting for a whole year almost. Probably a year. . 40%. And that's been sitting, like I say, for a whole year, so pretty unbelievable. I just cut a 2x6 off of this to lighten the boards up a little bit for me. They were getting kind of heavy. That's an 8-inch by 6-inch cant there now. I believe. 6 inch, a little more than 6. So I'm gonna cut another 2x out of this, then probably 2 1x because of the split in there. Let me see where that split ends. I might just cut this off here. Yeah, I think I'm gonna just cut this off. Check that's in there is only like maybe a 1/2 inch down now, so I should be able to cut all 2x out of this. I guess because of the way the log ended up, most of this is going to be, most of this is going to be quarter sawn, the rest of what's here. Because the Woodmizer can only cut to within an inch of the bed, what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up 2 inches from the bunk and cut off whatever I have there. Here is I have at this end I have about 2.5 inches. The reason for that is because I flipped it over and the mouth of that check was opening this up. It was also making it tilt. If you remember, there was stress on some of the boards, so now I've got some board hanging down on the bottom part of this. So what I'm going to have to do is flip this over actually to be able to get that bottom shaved off so I have a 2-inch board. I want you to look at this. It was warping while I was cutting it. You see this end, the size? And you see how it gets bigger down to that other end? And you can see it has a slight bow like this now that it's off the bunk. I'm going to lay it back on the bunk with the side that I just cut down, and then we'll see if we can't straighten that cut out. Good bend in it there. lot you can do with that. I put some weight on here to make this touch the bump. It's still off the bump slightly. So probably from back in here, I'm gonna have to shave that a little bit. Saying there that at that end of the board it was warped up a little bit, so I took that off by flipping it over on the straight side that I had just cut. So now I have a nice 2-inch board. So I'm going to go ahead and cut the flitches off. I'll get set up and then I'll turn the camera back on. Alright, so I have the flitches up there. And you can see I have my stops that I made in place. This back board here is a little wider than the bottom one. So I'm going to be taking off a 1x8. Or an 8-inch cut, I ought to say. I've got 8 inches down here. So what we want is 8 inches off the bump. I'm hoping to get a piece. quite four out of this. That's hardly worth fooling with. I thought I could get a 1x4 out of it, but it's too bad on the one side. Well, it feels good to be back on the mill. Now we got to get another oak over here. These boards here, I laid them on the thing here. There's so many, or on the horse, there's so much moisture in there, 40%, 39%, that I'm going to leave them sit out till tomorrow and then I'll put them in the kiln. They won't lose that much moisture because it's pretty overcast. It looks like it might even rain. shovel this up, I sort of tilt the shovel that way. I want to make sure any water runs off this thing. I need to get a longer piece of pipe. The pipe I have in there isn't long enough for the can hook. And this piece broke off on me. Kept tripping over this little piece here. I need to get about a 4-inch piece of 4-inch, or not a 4-inch, 3-foot piece of 4-inch pipe. That's what I need to fix that. I'm gonna get the leaf blower now and blow that out of there. I really like keeping it nice and neat. Have a good one, guys. All cleaned up, ready for tomorrow.